Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh and salam sejahtera. Very good morning, evening or good night. How are you? Bertemu kita kembali ke dalam siri kuliah yang seterusnya. To everyone attention, basically I already recorded the first version of my lecture, which is covered chapter 5 under the topic of belt and rope drives. That one I going to be upload into YouTube video by tomorrow, Monday, inshallah. Yet for this time, I think I just going to finish my lecture before we start to do our tutorial. Yeah. So I stop last time at this subtopic where we discuss clearly much into detail about the type of belt, where in the much more detailed subtopic we also discuss about the type of flat belt drives. Okay, so this is the flat belt drive. Basically, we got four types of flat belt, and every inch of details already been discussed throughout the class that have been recorded previously. So you just wait throughout my YouTube video, yeah. So I go on, I move along with my lecture. So in this topic, you know, I'm going to discuss a bit about velocity ratio of belt drive here. Yeah, so as we know, in the velocity ratio of the belt drive is a ratio. Yeah, it's a ratio between velocities of the driver and the follower or driven. Means it's a ratio between the velocity of the driver and the follower or driven, means the one that been the one that drives the timing belt is the shaft that been attached to the motor. So that one is the one that pull up, the one that pull and drive. So of course they got another mechanism, that the driven or the follower. So basically the ratio can be expressed in terms of mathematics. As we can see, here's the formulation where you got N2 over N1 equals to D1 over D2, where D1 is the diameter of driver and D2 is diameter of follower. Yeah, so if I may explain a bit. Okay, just imagine this one is driver and this one is follower. So we got belt drive here. Okay, this one is, you know, it turn following the clockwise. And that follow, you know, it turns anti-clockwise. You know, so it turns the belt, so the follower will follow. So D1, sorry, so I padam je, then I lukis balik. Therefore D1 is the diameter, this is D1 of driver, and this is D2 of follower, or the pulley that been driven by the driver. And then of course D1 is the speed of the driver, N1 is the speed of the driver, and then N2 is the speed of follower. And then as we know, this N, they got the unit to be RPM, they set the unit to be RPM. Okay, when the thickness of belt T is considered, let's say you consider the thickness, yeah. So here is the thickness lah. Let's say this is the thickness. So let's say you consider the thickness of the belt, then the formulation will be a bit changed from this formulation, where the formulation you're going to add up a thickness terminology, or the thickness is defined in this new equation, where you can see N2, which is the speed of follower divided by N1, the speed of driver equivalent to D1, the speed of the diameter of the driver plus T, its own thickness, divided by D2, the diameter of the follower plus T, which is the thickness of the follower. So this is what I call the velocity ratio of belt drive. Yeah. All right. So we move along. Another subtopic that we're going to cover is the velocity ratio of a compound belt drive. Sometimes the power is transmitted from one shaft to another. Yeah, like this, from one shaft to another. Yeah, from this shaft to this shaft. Okay, through a number of pulley as shown in figure 5, we know that velocity ratio of pulley 1 and 2 here, similar to a velocity ratio of pulley 3 and 4, multiplying the equation 1 Roman and 2 Roman, here we got this. It can be expressed throughout this equation, yeah. Okay. So where's figure 5? Here is figure 5. You got two or more than two shaft, more or less. Yeah. You got shaft 1. This is shaft 1. You got shaft 2, and then you got shaft 3. So here is the driver. It drive, and then this one been the driven, and then of course this one is also the driver as well. Yeah, it can be in that kind of arrangement as well. Yeah. So basically, the formulation can be equate in terms of this sort of equation. Yeah. Clear. Okay. Then I'm going to move on to slip of belt. In previous article, we have discussed the motion of belt and shaft, assuming a firm frictional grip between the belts of and the shaft. But sometimes the frictional grip becomes insufficient. Yeah, this may cause some forward motion of the driver without carrying the belt with. Means they got a slip, you know. Just imagine we got a pulley, you know. Just imagine we got a pulley. Here is a pulley, yeah. The thickness of the pulley. And then at the same time, we also have a belt. Now, what happened is it slipped, yeah. Or dalam bahasa Melayunya, in Malay, dia tak lekat. So what happened, even though this one pusing, this one is crank, still it cannot pull the belt. So this is the issue. Yeah. These two mechanism, the belt and the pulley is not attached properly. So what happened, the pulley is rotating on its own without pulling the belt. So that's the issue, yeah. Slip of belt. So this is what you call slip of belt, and generally expressed as a percentage, yeah. So here is very, you know, simple theory or equation, you know, to define this sort of issue. Okay, as it tells you here, you know, just imagine that you got S1 percentage is equal to slip between the driver and the belt, and S2 percentage is slip between the belt and the follower. So the velocity of the belt passing over the driver per second, you got V equivalent to pi D1 multiplied by N1 divided by 60. And then you need to minus with pi multiplied by D1 N1 divided by 60 and time, you know, multiply by S1 divided by 100 equivalent to this equation lah, more or less. Yeah, you can read and understand the whole equation. Yeah. And the velocity of belt passing over the follower per second is like this one expressed by this equation. Yeah. Okay. And then they got this kind of equation as well. But I think this is not fully covered throughout your syllabus. But still, it's a good thing to know, since this one can be your knowledge added throughout. Yeah. All right. So basically, this is one of the few topics that we need to just, you know, just to have a sort of discussion throughout. This is a clip of belt. This is happen when the belt pass from the slack side, yeah, from the slack side to the tight side. Yeah, we remember this is the pulley. This is the pulley. So this is the slack side. This is the tight side. This is slack. This is tight. So what happened when belt passes from the slack side to the tight side? Certain portion of the belt extend and contracts. Of course, lah, the belt itself is extend and contract. Yeah, the kembang kuncup lah, more or less. Okay. Due to these changes of length, there's a relative motion between the belt and pulley surfaces. This relative motion is termed as creep. Yeah, because this one is a mechanism that done all over time. So you got, you know, you got things that been put out, you know, and contract over and over and over throughout years. So what happened? It going to worn out and being a creep. Yeah, it worn and creep. Creep ni dalam bahasa Melayu keleheran. Bukan keleheran. Something lah, means it started to worn out. So the getah tu dah tak berapa stiff dah. Yeah, or less the stiffness is somehow depleted. Alright. Okay, so now the total effect of the creep is reduced slightly by the speed of driven pulley or follower considering the creep. Okay, so this is the formulation lah. I mean, like you can read throughout and then you can use that. You can use this sort of formulation throughout any question that been given. Yeah. Okay, so I move on. The length of an open belt drive, and this is in this case, both the pulley rotate at the same direction. Yeah. This one lah. You can see those pulley rotate in the same direction without any issue, I suppose. Okay. So what seems to be the problem? In this case, let's say R1 and R2, radius of the larger and smaller pulley, X distance. Okay, these are all the terms that already given lah, yeah. Let the belt leave the larger pulley at E and G. At E and G. Here, eh. At E and G, okay, let the belt leave the larger pulley at E and G and the smaller pulley at F and H, as shown in figure 10, through O2 and O1. From the geometry of the figures, we find that O2M will be perpendicular to, okay, so you want to calculate length of open belt drive, yeah? So something like that lah. Okay. So more or less, this is the equation given. Okay. And then this is all the equation lah, yeah? Okay. So another case of the crossbed drive, and as what we discussed in previous recorded video, and this is the, what I call that, the formulation on, in order to solve the problem lah, you want to find the L or the length. Okay. All right. So another thing is we want to know the power transmitted by a belt. Okay, so let T1 and T2 tension in the tight and slack side of the belt. Okay, this one is all been defined throughout. So you can use this sort of equation to solve your the problem, the problem given, yeah. Ratio of driving tension for flat belt drive. Consider a driven pulley rotating in a clockwise direction as shown in figure 2. Let T1 tension in the belt of on the right side. This one is all things that been given lah. So I think you can read throughout. This is all the formulation, and then this one is how to find the angle of contact. And this is the maximum tension of belt. Okay, this is sort of formulation we're going to going through into details after we move on to our tutorial. So it's going to be much more better since we're going to practice it throughout. Yeah, plus a bit of my a bit of my explanation through explanation about the equation. Yeah. So this is the example for our case. Fair enough, you can look up to look throughout the question, but still I think this will be okay, and then this will be the end of my lecture, yeah. Because after this, I'm going to discuss throughout the tutorial and the question after, yeah. So, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Thank you.